Good evening everyone, welcome to NPTEL tutorial session for the course Principles of Organic Synthesis, and which is taken by Professor Punniyamurthy from IIT Guwahati, and I am Sri Lakshmi. Yes, so here I am, we are having our 10th tutorial sessions for this course. So okay, so in the 10th tutorial session, mainly we have seen about aromatic diazonium salt. Okay, so far we have seen the discussion of week 9 week lectures and the problems related to that, and previous like week assignments also we have been discussing. So today we will be first having a brief discussion about the lecture 19 and lecture 20, which was about aromatic diazonium salts. And then we will be having our discussion on some problems related to that topic. I hope my audio is visible to you. Audio, I am audible. Okay. So in the week 10 lectures, we have seen several reactions regarding this aromatic diazonium salts. So firstly, we have seen the preparation properties of this diazonium salts, like this diazonium salts will be mostly ionic, water soluble, colorless crystalline, so colorless crystalline solids, and they react only when it is warmed because they are soluble in water. And if any electron withdrawing group is attached to the aromatic nucleus, the aromatic amine is difficult to diacetize because the nucleophilicity of the amine nitrogen is reduced by the partial withdrawal of the unshared electron pair to the nucleus. And also we have seen some named reactions in the first lecture, that is for the synthesis we have seen the grease diacetization reaction and wit diacetization method. And regarding the reactions involving the aromatic diazonium salts, we have seen this Schiemann reaction, Sandmeyer reaction, and Mirwin reaction. So first we will be discussing on this. Okay, sorry, let me share the slides. I hope it's visible now. Yeah. So firstly, we will be discussing directly the reactions of aromatic diazonium salt. That the first reaction is Schiemann reaction. So this is the Schiemann reaction, which is basically the diazotization of this aromatic amines, that is anilines or aniline derivative, in the presence of this HBF4. We will be getting, that is whatever diazonium salt is formed in the first step in the presence of NaNO2 and HCl, first this N2 plus will be formed here, which upon treatment with this HBF4, we are getting this fluoride substituted product. So this reaction is known as Ball-Schiemann reaction. So if we are looking at the reaction, what is happening? This amino group is getting substituted with this fluoride, but this is not direct substitution. Firstly, we have to convert the amine group into amine group into the corresponding diazonium salt. So what is happening here basically is that, yeah, first this NaNO2 and HCl, which will produce this NO2H, which in presence of HBF4, it will get protonated to form this, let me take the pen. Yeah, it will get protonated to form this compound, this oxonium ion, and then this oxygen lone pairs will fall over here, and this will eliminate as water molecule to form this oxonium ion, and that will be stabilized by this tetrafluoroboron cation. And then this nitrogen over this, yeah, when it is treated with this aromatic amines, that is aniline or its derivative, this, what happened, this attacked over this nitrogen and this bond is shifted to hydrogen, that is this nitrogen lone pair will attack over this electrophilic center and this bond is shifted to here. So we will be getting this intermediate. Then what is happening, proton hydride or proton transfer, we can tell, that is from this proton is transferring to this O, and this bond will be shifted to here, and this positive charge on this nitrogen will be stabilized, so that we will get this intermediate. Then again in the presence of H plus, this will get protonated and it will eliminate to form this intermediate. So this is basically the diazonium salt. Then what is happening in the next step is this N2 will be released to form this carbocation. So this is the intermediate that we are getting after diazotization. After diazotization, once the N2 will be eliminated, we will be getting this carbocation, that is we will be getting like this, a carbocation will be formed, upon which this fluoride minus will go and attack on that carbocation. From this, BF4 minus and BF3 will be eliminated, which is a stable molecule also, to form this aromatic fluorides. So this is basically Ball-Schemann reaction, diazotization of aromatic amines. Firstly, it will form the diazonium salt. Then in the presence of HBF4, thermal decomposition will be yielding aryl fluorides. So this is known as Ball-Schemann reaction. So I will give you some time to go through this mechanism. 2 minutes maybe you can take. Then we will go to the next reaction. Moving to the next reaction, that is Sandmeyer reaction, which is also a very basic reaction which we are learning since our school itself. So that is basically the substitution of this amine with this halides in presence of copper. So here also what is happening, this aromatic amines by treating with this NaNO2 or this ONO, which is also the source of this N2, like source of this diazonium salt, we will be getting this aryl diazonium halide, and which upon treatment with this copper 1 halide through a single electron transfer process, we will be getting this aryl halides or aryl nitriles, and N2 will be released. So this is known as Sandmeyer reaction. So here what is happening is that first this diazonium salt upon treatment with this copper 1 halide, it will be forming this radical ion, that is this type of species will be formed, which upon elimination of this N2, that is copper is giving one electron and getting oxidized to copper 2, and here N2, when N2 is released, here one radical will be formed, that is like this. One radical will be formed at over this center, and to that, when this from this copper 2 halide, when the halide get released, it will be converted back into this copper 1 halide, and that released halogen radical will be attacking over this, and that will be combining together to form the aryl halide or nitrile. So this Anmeyer reaction is basically taking place through this single electron transfer reaction, which is mediated by copper 1 halides. So this is also substitution reaction. So far we have seen two substitution reactions. One is Boltz-Schemann reaction and the second one is Sandmeyer's reaction. Now moving to the third reaction of this disodium salt, which is Meerwein arylation, or maybe I will give 2 minutes for just going through this two reactions, Boltz-Schemann reaction as well as the Sandmeyer's reaction. Okay, now moving to the next reaction, which is Meerwein arylation, which is also another reaction utilizing this disodium salt. So here what is happening, this disodium salt, when we are treating with this alpha beta unsaturated compounds or this alkenes where this electron withdrawing group is attached, and it will be catalyzed by a transition metal, this N2 will be eliminated and we will be getting this kind of compound. So this is an example for arylation reaction. So what is happening here is that once this disodium salt is formed in presence of this copper 1 halide, again as we discussed in the Sandmeyer's reaction, here also a single electron transfer is taking place from copper 1 to this disodium salt to form this radical, and which upon elimination of the nitrogen molecule will form this benzene radical. So now this bond will be homolytically cleaved to form a diradical over this center, and these two radicals will be combining to form a bond over here, and this radical will be here. Then again in presence of copper halide, like when the single electron transfer happened here in the presence of copper 1 halide, what is remaining is this copper 2x2 that will be remaining after the electron transfer. So in the presence of that, whatever got eliminated, again it is undergoing a single electron, or again it is undergoing an electron transfer where this copper halide is getting regenerated, and this will be forming a cation over here. That is, this is taking this this radical also and converting it into this copper 1 halide, and here a cation is forming. Then in the presence of any halide or any like nucleophile can attack over this positively charged electrophilic center, and that will be creating this compound. Then this halides are good leaving group, so that will leave as this HX taking the proton from the next carbon to that alpha carbon to that, so that will be eliminated to form this alkene. So this reaction is known as Meerwein arylation. basically it is the reaction of this diisonium salt upon this alkenes having an electron withdrawing group adjacent to it, which is catalyzed by a transition metals to form this conjugated compounds. So I hope the mechanism is clear. First single electron transfer will take place, and then here homolysis is happening. These radicals will combine, and then again electron transfer will result in the formation of this cation, and upon treating with this X minus, which will be already there in the reaction medium, it will attack over this carbocation, and then elimination of that HX like hydrogen halides to get this alkenes as a product. So this is the third reaction which we are seeing now. So firstly we saw the Ball-Schemann reaction, then we have seen the Sandmeyer's reaction, and this is Meerwein annihilation. Moving to the next reaction, which is Gomberg reaction. So this is basically a type of coupling reactions, we can say. So a benzene ring in presence of another aromatic diisonium salt in the presence of this hydroxyl ion, it will be coupled together. That is, this carbon coupling is taking place to form this kind of compounds. So here what is happening is that first, in the presence of this OH minus lone pair of this oxygen can attack over this nitrogen. And as a result, this bond will be shifted over this positively charged nitrogen. So we will get this kind of species. Then the next diisonium salt molecule will be attacking over this O minus will attack over the nitrogen of next molecule to form this kind of intermediate. So then elimination of N2 will be resulting in this intermediate. So that is basically this, and this is same. So what they wanted to mean is that here we can see an ion is there, and here it is a radical. And when it combined with this benzene radical, it will form this intermediate with a radical over this center, and which upon protonation which upon the release of this proton, it will regain the aromaticity. So it is not basically proton, this hydrogen atom removal will be resulting in the regaining the aromaticity to get this coupled product. So that is basically Gomberg reaction. So what's happening here is that first hydroxyl ion is attacking over this nitrogen center to form this radical. Then again the second molecule of diisonium salt will be there already in the reaction mixture. So this O minus can attack over that center to form this intermediate. Then N2 release will be resulting in this radical, and this radical when it combined together like with benzene radical, when it combined by the release of this N2, we will be getting this compound. And when this bond is homolytically cleaved, here one radical will be formed which will combine to form this couple product. So this reaction is known as Gomberg reaction. Moving to the next reaction, which is Schorr annihilation. So that is basically the reaction of this aromatic amines in presence of this sodium nitrite, HCl and copper to form this carbon-carbon bond. So here also this is getting eliminated. So first diisotization is happening, and then this is getting eliminated. So here what is happening is that in the presence of NaNO2 and H+, this is the reactive intermediate in the diisonium salt. So this NH2 will attack over this positively charged nitrogen center to form this intermediate, and then this will take up a proton and it will be leaving as water molecule to get this diisonium salt, which in the presence of copper will be eliminated by the single electron transfer. It will form a cation over this center, radical over this center. And when this radical is formed, this bond can cleave and this radical can form here as well as here. So once it is combined, we will get another ring here. So that is basically happening here as well. So here what is happening is that we have this aromatic ring over here, then this keto group and this aromatic ring. So in the presence of copper, we know diisotization and elimination of the nitrogen molecule will be resulting in the formation of this radical. And when the bond here will get cleaved homolytically, here and here one radical will be formed. So these two radicals will be combined, and then again one proton, hydrogen atom abstraction will result in the regaining of aromaticity. So this reaction is known as Schorr arylation. Moving to the next reaction, which is Jab-Klingman synthesis. So this is basically the reaction between this kind of beta keto acid we have taken, or we can take beta keto esters, which in the presence of this aromatic diazonium salt, we will be getting this product. That is, here this is an example where the nitrogen is not getting eliminated. That is, the nitrogen atom in the starting material is regained here also, but in all the other reactions which we have seen, the nitrogen is getting eliminated and this carbon-carbon or carbon heteroatom bond is getting formed. But here in this reaction, the nitrogen is retained as such. So here what is happening here is that first, in the presence of the base, a proton abstraction will take place from the here, because this is very acidic proton, to form a carbocation which will attack upon over this nitrogen center, and this bond will shift over here to form this intermediate. Then again base will abstract over this center to form this compound, that is OH minus will attack over this, this bond will be shifted to here to form this O minus, and when this minus charge will come back here, this bond will be shifted to here and this bond will shift to here to form, so that is, this bond is getting breaked to form this RCOH and this particular compound. Then what is happening, again this negative charge on this nitrogen will take up a proton from this carboxylic acid which got eliminated. So this will be RCOO minus, and we will get this hydrazone type of product as the major product. So this reaction is known as Jab-Klingman synthesis. So moving to the next reaction, that is Demjanov reaction, which we have seen in the lecture as the Stefano-Demjanov reaction. So this is basically as given here. It's a ring enlargement of amino-methyl cycloalkanes upon treatment with nitrous acid to the corresponding homologous cycloalkanols. So here this NH2, this 4-member cyclobutane substituted with this group, is getting converted into the cyclopentane ring, and this will be the minor product here. So here what is happening here is that, so first this nitrogen lone pair will attack over this nitrogen center from this HNO2, and that will form this compound, which this free hydroxyl group, one of the free hydroxyl group is getting protonated, and it will get eliminated, and this bond is shifting over here to form this intermediate. Then again this will get protonated, like water molecule can be eliminated, and this bond is shifting over here and this is shifting over here. It is taking up a proton. Then again it will take up a proton, and this bond, this lone pair is shifting over here to form this compound. Then what is happening here is that a bond migration is happening. That is, this bond is migrating over this center, and this is getting eliminated. So what is happening? This is going to here means a carbocation will be formed at the center, right? So in that carbocation, this hydroxyl group from the water molecule will be attacking to get this compound. So this is the ring enlargement reaction. So we started with here cyclopentane ring, and we have ended up with this cyclohexane ring. So this reaction is known as Stefano-Demjanov reaction. So So that was about the discussion on the week 10 week 10 lecture videos, where we have seen several named reactions. So the first one was Ball-Schumann reaction, then we have seen Sandmeyer reaction, then Meerwein annihilation, Gomberg reaction, Shor annihilation, Jap-Klingman synthesis, and the Stefano-Demjanow rearrangement. So far, if you have any doubts or questions regarding the reactions which we have discussed, please let me know.
Hello. Good evening, ma'am. Ma'am, actually, in past part, I not attended that time. So,
sorry, I couldn't get you.
In past part of the slide, I actually did not join. So okay.
So from where you have seen, which reaction you have seen?
I think Meerwein annihilation.
Yeah, that's clear, right? So firstly, we have discussed this Ball-Schumann reaction only, where this amino group is getting substituted with this fluoride. So that is basically simple reaction where this diazotization is happening. So we will be getting this intermediate. I hope that is clear, because when we are using this nitrous acid in presence of this HBF4, we will be getting this intermediate, which is our reactive species. And when it is treated with this aniline, this nitrogen lone pairs will attack over this nitrogen center that will be giving this product. Then this oxygen is getting protonated. This bond is shifting over here to form this intermediate. And again, this is getting protonated and it will leave out as water molecule to form this diazonium salt. So here this diazonium salt will be existing as this ARN plus triple bond N, and BF4 minus will be the corresponding anion. So then what is happening is that this will eliminate to form this BF4 minus and this AR plus. So this AR plus is resulting for the substitution, where this F minus from this BF4 minus will attack over this aromatic ring and BF3 will be eliminated and this aryl fluoride will be formed. So that is Ball-Schumann reaction. It's just substitution of this amino group with this fluoride. And the next reaction is similar, that is Sandmeyer reaction. So here what is happening is that we are converting this amino group into this corresponding halide by converting first into this aryl diazonium salt and then treating it with this copper 1 halide. So here, since we are using this metal, firstly, this radical will be formed. Like in Ball-Schumann reaction, what we have seen is the intermediate was this cation, where the F minus is attacking. So here, since we are utilizing a transition metal, here the reactive intermediate is this radical, not a cation. So to that cation, this halogen radical is attacking from this copper halide and we are getting the substituted product. So the overall result is same, but one time we are getting the intermediate, that is carbocation, and the next time we are in Sandmeyer reaction, we are getting this free radical intermediate. So these two were the reactions which we discussed before this Meerwein annihilation. Is it clear?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. So now we will move on to the question discussion. So the major product of the reaction. So here we are treating this aromatic compound which have NH2 as well as this fluoride and this substituent. When we are treating it with this HNO2 in presence of copper, bromide and HBr, which will be the major product. And you can try to guess the name of the reaction also.
It's like Sandmeyer reaction?
Yes, Sandmeyer reaction. So which will be the answer?
Fourth one,
yes. So this is the substituted product we are getting, and this is the mechanism which we already saw here earlier, replacement by the halogen, and it is Sandmeyer reaction. Moving to the next question. So here the major product of the reaction. So here we are treating this aniline. First step with the three equivalents of bromine, in the second step with this nitrous acid, and then with H3PO2. Here what will be happening?
Fourth one,
can you explain that, how it is happening?
Initially, as three equivalent of bromine was, the bromine will attach at ortho and para position.
Yes.
Then using nitric acid, it will convert it into diazonium salt.
Yes. And what is the role of this H3PO2? Okay, we will see. So the correct answer is option B. So first step is correct. That is, firstly, we will be getting this NH2, Br at ortho, two ortho positions and para position. Then by treating with this HNO2, we will be getting... Yeah, by treating with this HNO2, we will be getting the diazonium salt, and that once that N2 plus is eliminated, it will be... in radical form, or it will be existing in cationic form, right? Then this hypophosphoric phosphorus acid is actually serving as a hydrogen source. So whatever radical or cation is formed here, that will get protonated, and we will get the NH2 substituted with this hydrogen. So this is the replacement by hydrogen. That is the role of this H3PO2. Okay, so it won't be existing in this form because this is not a stable compound. This diazonium salts are not that much stable. We won't usually isolate that. We will be quenching it directly with any halide or any substitution we will be doing here at this center. So here when we are using H3PO2, it is actually the source of hydrogen, and that will replace this with the hydrogen. Okay. Okay. Moving to the next question, the major product of the reaction. So here also we are treating firstly with this NaNO2 HBr, and then the second condition we are treating with this alkene substituted with this CO2 Me group in presence of this copper oxide. So which reaction it is?
First one.
So which reaction it is? We have already seen this reaction today, I think. Yeah, this one. So here the correct answer is this option, option C. And this is an example for Mirvine annihilation. Mirvine annihilation is basically, or Mirvine reaction, basically the treatment of this disonium compound with this alkene in presence of copper to get this halo substituted product. And whatever I have shown is if we are heating the reaction or there is a possibility for elimination, this can eliminate like this, HCl molecule will be eliminated and here double bond will be formed. If that is not happening here, as in the case here, first with NaNO2 and HBr, this disonium salt is getting formed, and then that will in the presence of this copper chloride, this free radical will be formed, and then what is happening, that benzene radical is there. And this is our other reactant, that is double bond. CO2Me, and in the presence of this copper, this will also get homolytically cleaved, and here also radical will be formed, and this will be combining to form a bond over the center. And this radical, again in the presence of copper, it will be converted into a cation. To that, this HBr we are using, so Br minus will be attacking over that center to form this compound. So this is an example for Mirvine reaction. Sorry. Okay, so the correct answer is option C. If there was any heating condition or anything, we can directly write this B also if this HBr is getting eliminated in that case. Here, whatever you have told is also forming, like not exactly that, this is the byproduct, I think. Is it okay, the mechanism of Mirvine reaction?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So the next question is, we are treating this nitrobenzaldehyde, 2-nitrobenzaldehyde with this carboxylic acid, first with acetic anhydride, then with H2PDC, and then HNO2 in heating condition in presence of an acidic condition, which will be the major product here. Any idea what is happening here? Okay, so I have already given the answer. This is the answer. So maybe you can tell how it is forming. What is actually happening? Okay, so here what is happening is that this is an example for this show reaction. So first step, what is happening? Just condensation between this acid and this, like here, this proton will be abstracted and that will be attacking over this carbonyl carbon of this benzaldehyde. Then water molecule elimination, that is dehydration in the presence of this acetic anhydride, will be taking place to form this compound. So this is the first step in acetic anhydride condition. This is the compound form. Then in the second step, that is H2PDC condition, this NO2 will be first converted into NH2. And in the next step, when we are treating with this HNO2, in presence of that acid, nitrous acid we are using, so in that time this is getting converted into the corresponding diazonium salt. And then when we are heating the reaction mixture, what is happening? This bond is attacking over here to form this carbon-carbon bond, and since we are heating, this decarboxylation is also occurring to get this phenanthrene as the final product. So first step is this condensation reaction. This carbon will attack over this benzaldehyde. Then elimination of water molecule, we will get this double bond over this center. Then H2PDC reaction will convert this NO2 to NH2, which upon treatment with this HNO2, we will get this diazonium salt, and which upon heating, this bond will be attacking over here to form this six-membered ring, and upon heating, this CO2 elimination will also take place to form this phenanthrene molecule. Is it okay? Okay. So this is an example for Shaw reaction. Moving to the next question, the major product of the reaction. So here also we are treating this amino compound with first this ONO source, and then the second step with hydroquinone. What will be the major product?
Second one?
Yes, so which reaction it is again? Whatever we have seen just now, the same reaction, show reaction only, but only one change is that here we are using, instead of HNO2, we are using this as the source of disonium salt. So in the first step, what is happening? This NH2 is getting converted into N2+, and then N2+ will be eliminated, and here carbocation will be formed, and this bond will be attacking over this center, and then re-aromatization will happen to get this as the major product. Is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Moving to the next question. So here, this amide, when we are treating with this aryl disonium compound in presence of NaOH, which will be the major product. So which reaction this is? Okay, so here the correct answer is this one, that is option D. And this is an example for this Jab-Klingman reaction. So that is basically what is happening here is that this beta-keto ester we are converting into this aryl hydrazone. So that is also happening here also. Here this C double bond O OET will be there that we are converting into this compound by treating with this aryl disonium salt. So the general mechanism is like this. I hope this is clear. Okay.
And first one?
This is the correct answer. First one, not this one. First one is the correct answer, hydrazone. So what is happening here? First, this base will take out the proton from this center. So here negative charge will be formed. That negative charge is attacking over this nitrogen. So that is shown here. Actually, we will be getting this kind of an intermediate. One side we have amide here, another side we have ester group. Then again, in the presence of this OH minus. OH minus will attack over this carbonyl carbon center, and this acetic acid will be eliminated, and we will get this intermediate. Then whatever N minus is there, that will take up the proton from this acetic acid, and we will be getting this hydrazone as a major product. So I will show you here. Yeah, this is the reaction basically. First, deprotonation from here, and that will attack over the disodium salt to form this intermediate. Then again, OH minus will attack over this center. And here what is happening when OH minus is attacking, in our case, that ester is there. So OET is a good leaving group. It is getting eliminated also. And then whatever resulting N minus will take a proton from the eliminated acid and will be giving this hydrazone as the major product. So it's an example for this Jap-Klingman reaction. Yeah. Is it okay? Okay, moving to the next question. The major product of the reaction. So this compound upon treatment with this NaNO2 in acetic acid, which will be the major product? Which reaction it is and which will be the major product? Yes. So which will be the product here?
Fourth
or second one. So what's happening here first?
First, NPTEL plus.
Yeah, disodization will be happening then.
Ring expansion will happen.
Yes, so which bond will be migrating? If this bond is migrating, we will be getting fourth option. But if this bond is migrating, we will be getting second option. Here I think both are same only, right? So here also we have this is trisubstituted, and this also we have trisubstituted. So if maybe I think both are possible here. So either this or this can form, right? If this bond is migrating, we will be getting this one, and if this bond is migrating and this N2 plus is eliminating, we will be getting this one as a major product. So this is the mechanism. So first this oxygen lone pairs will fall over here, and this disodization is happening, and then this oxygen lone pair will fall over here, and this bond will migrate towards the center, and N2 will be eliminated. So ring expansion is taking place. Okay. Usually if there is aryl or alkyl groups are there, different groups are there, then we can compare the compare the migratory aptitude of the bond, but here both are similar, so I think maybe both are forming. Okay.
Yes,
so the next question, the major product of the reaction. So here we are treating with this amino benzoic acid with this HNO2 H plus in the first step, and with this methyl dimethyl substituted aniline in the second step, which will be the major product.
Second one?
No. Just now we have seen the mechanism, right? Just try to guess what is happening here.
in this case, in this nitrogen gave its lone pair to the aromatic ring, and then the para position at the para position it will add to the
firstly, this intermediate is getting formed between this and this one. Okay, then nitrogen lone pair is attacking over that nitrogen center, and then this is forming. In our case, we have an extra carboxylic acid over this center. So, moving to the last question, which of the following is an example for modern dye? Modern dyes are basically the compounds. Compounds which give colors. So, this third one is an example for modern dye. It will be having aluminium also. Potassium or aluminium compounds will be used mostly. Okay, so that was the 10 questions for the week 10 lectures. I hope the portion is clear and the topics are clear and all the reactions are clear. If you have any questions, you can ask.
If while solving weekly assignment, I have any doubt, can I mail to you?
But do you have my mail ID?
No.
Or what you can do is, there is one section where you can ask your doubts, right? So you can post there, and in the next session, maybe I can ask that, solve that problem for you. Is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So you are doing MSc or?
No, ma'am. Actually, in this year, actually, I joined IIT Bhubaneswar as a PhD scholar.
Okay, fine. So you are working on organic synthesis?
Yes, in polymer chemistry.
Polymer chemistry, okay. So now your coursework is going on?
Yes, in autumn session actually I joined.
Okay. Yeah, if you have any doubts regarding the topics or any questions, you can just post there. I will discuss that in the session.
They actually have a discussion link.
I think one discussion forum is there, right, in that NPTEL session. When we log in, we can see in the course tab, there is one discussion forum.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah, there you post any queries and I will answer that. Okay, thank you for joining. See you next Saturday then.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, at when will be the exam occur?
Exam, I think after October only. So till October 30th, I have got the deadline to complete the tutorial session. So mostly after that only the exam will be. Mostly in November, I think.
Okay.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.